Okay, so the last topic of our lecture today is time determinants and progression of the Karyos lesion. As far as we know, we have primary factors affecting in the dental caries, tooth, plaque, and diet. طبعا احنا التوث يعني التوث itself, the plaque يعني microorganisms or the bacteria that is in the plaque, والدايت ان احنا الكربوهيدرات او sugary intake. هلا, at first sight, these circles consist a simple model to explain caries risk, which is represented by the overlap of the three main circles, tooth, diet, and the plaque. حكينا يعني best describe dental caries as a multifactorial disease is the overlap circles. يعني أنا إذا one of these factors does not present, then the dental caries will not develop. With time, the circle has been supplemented with other factors, اللي هم حكينا عنهم secondary factors, اللي هم time, لأن بدنا وقت, fluoride, saliva, socioeconomic status. When one of the risk factors increases, حكينا عنهم هم risk factors أو حكينا secondary factors that modify the disease, the respective circle become larger. For example, is one of the اللي هي hyposalivation, حكينا إحنا عن saliva. فصارت السيركل كبيرة. في عنا the three main circles أو three main factors, طبعا in the presence of time. التايم يعني هو موجود دائما, بس هنا يعني they consider it different box, they consider it as يعني modifying factors, but it is not, it is by the way, it is a primary factor, التايم لازم يكون في تايم, لانه رح نحكي شوي عن the progression of dental caries ونبين كيف التايم is an important factor in the development of the carious lesion. بس المعنى انه في عندنا other factors that increase the circles should be present. These other factors outside the main three circles نسميهم secondary او modifying factors, واحنا already شرحنا عنهم. ليش هنا يعني احنا رجعنا حكينا عن الفاكتورز؟ لانه رح نحكي عن التايم. التايم فاكتور is very important. Caries is not a chronic disease. A chronic disease إنه بيضلوا بصير develop over time and cannot be reversed. بينما الكاريز, its effect can be arrested or completely repaired. يعني الكاريز at some point زي ما حكينا can be repaired if enough time is given for remineralization and the time, the certain point, time determinant here we consider إنه إحنا إذا we capture the carious lesion in a specific time and we have time also for remineralization, and the factors of remineralization happen in a given time. Caries lesion does not develop overnight, but take time. This is very important. يعني الكاريز lesion ما بتصير خلال يومين, ثلاثة, شهر, شهرين, سنة. طبعا this depends على الكاريز activity of the patient. يعني في الهاي كاريز risk patients, إذا بتتذكروا سميناها rampant caries, كان الكاريز development involve many teeth يعني with short period of time. بس احنا بنحكي عن الافريج بيرسون, not the high caries risk person, بنحكي عن average person. Average carious lesion take time. هلا it may take years for cavitation to occur, which give us the dentist and the patient time for preventive treatment strategies. ليش مهم نعرف هاي الشغلة انه it take years؟ معناته مثلا اذا في عنا we capture incipient lesions. هلا بتعرفوا شو يعني incipient lesion, a lesion that is enamel only. This means that we have time for this to remineralize. We have time and before it reaches the dentin and cause cavitation that needs restoration. This is why it is important here to know that caries does not develop يعني in short period of time. It takes years for cavitation to occur. فمعناته في عنا احنا فرصة ان نعمل remineralization and instruct the patient to do flossing, for example, better oral hygiene, cleaning, give him fluoride in order to reverse the caries process and prevent it from reaching a point of restoration or no return. Teeth consist of calcium phosphate mineral that demineralize when the environmental pH lowers. So far we know this. as the environmental pH recovers, إذا كان في عندنا الفرصة in the oral cavity، أوكي، ومن هنا بنرجع هنا نعمل إحنا ريكاب لكل اللي أخذناه، إذا بتتذكروا الـ ecological plaque hypothesis، إنه كيف إحنا السايت أو الميكرو environment كان favors إنه الـ environment كلها، إنه يصير عندنا recovery للـ pH، وإنه يرجع الـ pH يرتفع، then dissolved calcium and phosphate can reprecipitate or remaining mineral crystals ونسميها remineralization اللي هي عكس الـ demineralization. But unfortunately, remineralization slower process than demineralization. يعني الليجن حتى إنها ترجع تعمل remineralization it takes longer time than التايم اللي اخذته وهي وفي عندنا demineralization or formation of caries. ليش احنا هون demineralization و remineralization؟ زي ما حكينا انه المهم نعرف هاي الاشياء لكم بتاخذ الليجن حتى to develop او to progress. Okay, because we have time for remineralization. وهون حكينا كمان نرجع للإيكولوجيكال بلاك هايبوثيسيس، إحنا بنحكي عن المايكرو انفايرمنت around the lesion. If the micro environment around the lesion favors إنه الانفايرمنت pH كلها to recover وترتفع again, then it will favors remineralization and still a lesion in the incipient okay stage of development. When remineralization is given enough time, it can eliminate the damage done during demineralization. But in the absence of this, the caries process fully progress and will, the lesion will develop. For many years, much emphasis was given to the pre-eruptive effect of fluoride improving the quality of the dental hard tissues. It's now clear that post-eruptively used fluoride is more protective against caries. شو يعني؟ هلا role of fluoride. حكينا إنه if we capture the أو إنه the pH cell recovery, the incipient lesion أو lesion in the enamel can be reversed. طبعاً in the aid of the fluoride. فالفلورايد بيساعد في remineralization. هلا رح نشوف كيف. فالفلورايد very important element in the process of remineralization. هلا كانوا بالأول they thought إنه the pre eruptive يعني احنا في عندنا stage of a pre-eruptive new means يعني before the eruption of the tooth in the oral cavity يعني during the formation of the tooth. اوكي يعني انك تعطي فلورايد. طبعا اذا بتتذكروا كمان حكينا الفلورايد لما حكينا عن السلايفا الفلورايد in the plasma is very little. عادة إحنا بنعتمد على الفلورايد from external resources. يعني إحنا بنجيب الفلورايد للأورال كافيتي إما عن طريق الماوث رينسز أو البارنيشز أو عن طريق الأكل اللي بياكله المريض. أوكي بس in some way we depend on the fluoride from the external sources لأنه الفلورايد بالبلازما is very little. هلا كانوا يعتقدوا إنه if you give fluoride before the eruption of the teeth in the oral cavity is more important than after the eruption of the teeth or in the of the tooth. نحكي هلا level of tooth in the oral cavity. Now they found no. It is the most important for protection against caries is the fluoride that is an exposure of the fluoride to the teeth after eruption of the oral cavity is more important or more protective against dental caries. هلا كيف عرفوا انه الفلورايد انه effective in the, the resistance of dental caries by accident? They found it was noticed that excessive fluoride in the drinking water, الفلورايد منقص part per million. Okay, per million, and إذا كان أكثر من 2 resulted in molting appearance of enamel, enamel fluorosis إحنا بنسميه. مشكلته إنه إذا زادت كمية الفلورايد ممكن يأثر على الأسنان. Enamel fluorosis طبعاً رح تاخذوا عنها بعدين إنها different degrees starts من white opacities على tooth structure بعدين بصير في عنا brownish discoloration وممكن يعمل deformation للأسنان ويعمل pitting وhypomineralization of the teeth. Okay. هلا بس شو لاحظوا كمان انه الاكسس فلورايد ان ذا درينكينج ووتر يعني انجيشن اوف فلورايد ثرو ذا ان درينكينج ووتر ريزلت ان مولتينج اوف تيث يعني دنتال فلوروسيس اند اولسو ريزلت ان لو بريفالنس اوف دنتال كاريز يعني هدول الاسنان على الرغم من انهم يعني شويه صار شكلهم او تلونوا وصار فيهم ديسكالريشن اوكي وممكن يكون في ديفورميشن لكنهم كانوا مور ريزيستنس اوف دنتال كاريز فذيس بيد attention to the effect of fluoride in the protection of dental caries, okay? Later on, studies found that when the drinking water contained about one part per million, يعني محدد, the teeth, يعني not more than one part per million, the teeth of the inhabitants of that area, يعني سكان المنطقة, had a low caries prevalence but no signs of dental fluorosis. Okay, يعني صار في عنا إذا كان the amount of fluoride in the drinking water not more than one part per million, we have the effect of a protection the teeth against dental caries, but we don't have the side effect of causing problems to the teeth like discoloration and deformation, okay? But because of some problems with water fluoridation, يعني إنهم يتحكموا بكمية الفلورايد, الwater fluoridation رح تاخذه كمان في the course of a preventive dentistry, it's not easy. لأنك أنت متحكم كمية الفلورايد, أنت بتعرفش الكمية الفلورايد اللي بياخدها patients من other sources, for example, okay? But this is one of, now we have many limitations of the water fluoridation, but this one of the limitations. فصار عندنا alternative methods of supplementing fluoride intake has been developed. يعني some people may be given tablets مثلا, بس طبعا under supervision of the dentist or the specialist, the pedodontist, إذا كانوا children, to control the amount of fluoride. بس إحنا هلأ بنعتمد أكثر على ما إنه إحنا يعني they found إنه post-eruptive fluoride, okay, exposure, يعني after the eruption of the teeth, معناته إحنا بنعتمد أكثر على local fluoride application, يعني بنعتمد على نستخدم fluoridated toothpaste, fluoridated mouth rinses, نستخدم varnishes, ممكن نحطها in the gels in the dental office, okay, فهلا بنعتمد أكثر على local delivery of fluoride and, through يعني external sources زي ما حكينا. Fluoride toothpaste is by far the most frequently used fluoride agent in the world, okay? يعني أكثر إشي مستخدم هو fluoridated toothpaste, but is used regularly for, unfortunately, fewer than 10% of the world's population, about a third of the population of the industrialized countries. But it is very effective in reducing the dental caries, okay? هلا crystalline structure of enamel عشان نعرف الإفكت of fluoride. Enamel, بجوز أنا حكيتها كمان before in previous lectures. Enamel is composed of hydroxyapatite crystal. It is not اللي هو Ca10, PO4, taken 6, OH, taken 2. It's not a pure hydroxyapatite. It's also non-apatite faces. في عنا other forms, other يعني components form the crystalline structure of enamel. Okay, amorphous calcium phosphate or carbonate. Enamel is porous, okay, allowing ions to diffuse in it. So the composition of the hydroxyapatite lattice can vary throughout its structure. يعني هلا الهيدروكسيابتايت مش كلها نفس الشيء. يعني ممكن and throughout the structure of the enamel. Okay, يعني احنا الenamel is porous. It can take up minerals from the oral cavity as it can deposit as a result of demineralization the minerals of it out of the enamel. But it can take up many minerals الموجودين في saliva and in the oral cavity. هلا كمان one of the characteristics of the crystal lattice of the enamel هي hydroxyapatite crystal that it has the capacity to substitute other ions of appropriate size and shape, يعني تبدل اللي هي هاي احنا الكريستال حكينا انها formed of hydroxyapatite Ca10, PO4, taking 6, OH2. هلا any of these elements of the crystal can be substituted by other minerals if they can suitable a charge at home with size, okay? For example, within the lattice, calcium can be exchanged for radium, strontium, and hydrogen ion, and phosphate can be changed for carbonic acid, and hydroxyl for fluoride. يعني هذا اللي بهمنا. اوكي هذا رح تاخذوه في اماكن ثانيه بس اللي بدنا نوصل له انه احنا يعني من الفكره هاي انه الكريستال اللاتس ان ذا كريستال اوكي كان بي الايونز ان ذا كريستال كان بي ريبليسد باي اذر ايونز ذا سيم سايز اند شيب موجودين في الاورال كافيتي. اللي احنا بدنا نوصل له هون انه الهيدروكسيل كان بي ريبلاس فور فلورايد. الهيدروكسيل الموجود اللي هي OH هاي الهيدروكسيل جروب اوكي سميها هيدروكسيل جروب كان بي ريبليسد وذ فلورايد. اوكي وات از ذا ادفانتج اوف ذس اوكي انه الفلورايد بتكون عندنا بدل الهيدروكسيل هيدروكسي ابيتايت بصير عندنا فلورو ابيتايت. بس فلورو ابيتايت يعني بصير CA 10 PO4 تيكن 6 F تيكن 2. اوكي هاي الفلورو ابيتايت كريستال از مور ريزيستنت فور ذا اسيد اتاك ذان ذا هيدروكسي ابيتايت كريستال. اوكي سو ذيس از واي فلورايد وان واي هاو فلورايد بروتكت اجينست دنتال كاريز ميك ذا تو ستراكشر اتسلف مور ريزيستنس فور ذا اسيد اتاك. اوكي واضحه هون سو فار؟ ماشي. هلا في عنا different ways حكينا of deposition in fluoride in enamel. في عنا حكينا pre-eruptive و post-eruptive. The pre-eruptive هي during tooth formation and after calcification but before eruption. يعني انتو بتعرفوا انه tooth بتكون in the jaw. اوكي فبصير عندنا formation of the tooth بعدين بصير عندنا deposition or calcification بعدين بصير له eruption. فهلا في عندنا those stages انه في الفلورايد intake للtooth structure ممكن يكون during tooth formation او after calcification يعني بعد ما يصير calcification of the tooth structure but لسه ما عمل eruption in the oral cavity or after eruption. فهلا during حكينا انه they found انه after eruption now is more important for the protection against dental caries than the pre-eruptive fluoride intake. Hala, low concentration is deposited during tooth formation because of low fluoride concentration in tissues fluids. Asla min wen tiji tissue fluids, yani min the plasma of the blood. Fakana already ihna anna low concentrations of fluoride. Hala, after calcification and before eruption, more fluoride is taken up by the surface enamel, which is in contact with the tissue fluids. But the most important will after eruption and throughout life. يعني بستمر مدام في عنا fluoride exposure. عشان هيك هون بتيجي أهمية إنه to give fluoride supplements, fluoride from other sources. حكينا إنه local through rinses, toothpaste, gels, varnishes, whatever. The enamel continue to take up fluoride from the external environment throughout life. عشان هيك دائما لازم يكون في عنا source of fluoride in the oral cavity because this is the most important factor that may affect the development of dental caries and the progression of the carious lesion. The fluoride content of intact surface is much more higher than the interior enamel and in contact with the external environment. But tend to be extremely variable. يعني هي not distributed regularly between teeth. حتى إنه between the primary and permanent. قدرة the primary teeth إنه to absorb or to diffuse the fluoride into the enamel is different between primary and permanent. Between individuals, طبعاً, because of different of the fluoride exposure, different teeth in the same individual, حتى يعني لأنه إحنا in the oral cavity, and even different surfaces of the tooth. Okay, keep different surfaces of the tooth. رح نحكي عنها بعد شوي, بس هلا رح نحكي عن the cardiostatic mechanisms of fluoride. Why is fluoride important? Okay, إنه مش بس الفلورايد increase the resistance of the enamel crystal structure للفلوروابيتايت but إلو other factors. One of these factors اللي هي الكاريوستاتيك ميكانيزم of fluoride once tooth have erupted fluoride inhibit demineralization. Okay precipitation of this allow إنه reprecipitation of dissolved calcium and phosphate فهو inhibit demineralization promote remineralization. Okay part of the precipitation is on the surface, which narrow the pores of the enamel surface, okay, which prevent acid penetration, فهو promote remineralization, thus encouraging repair or arrest of carious lesion, delaying the lesion progression, okay, so prevent against dental caries and delay the carious lesion progression, so it both inhibit demineralization and promote remineralization. And even fluoride can exert bactericidal or enzymatic, anti-enzymatic effect. Okay, enzymes of the bacteria. فهو has a bactericidal effect. Interfere with the ionic bonding during pellicle and plaque formation onto surface. Okay, حكينا عنها هلا ما حكينا عن the plaque. وimprove enamel crystal structure اللي هي الفلوروابيتايت وبالتالي it is more resistance for the acid attack. So all these five reasons is why fluoride important in the cardiostatic mechanism, our cardiostatic ability to prevent the dental caries and prevent also or delay the progression of the carious region. First, because it inhibits demineralization, it promotes remineralization, it has a bactericidal or anti-enzymatic effect, it inhibits the bonding of the plaque formation on the tooth surface, and it improves the enamel crystal structure, it makes it more resistant for the acid attack by the formation of the fluoroapatite crystal instead of the hydroxyapatite crystals. Hella, caries lesion progress more slowly than they did several decades ago, which is increase in the use of fluoride. يعني هلا حتى the progression of dental caries قل مع استخدام الفلورايد. حكينا إنه the prevalence of dental caries decreased. Also, the progression of the carious lesion is slowed down by the exposure of dental caries or the use of dental of fluoride. About 50% of the enamel fissure lesions had progressed to involve dentin within 2 years, while 70% had become dentinal lesion after 4 years. Okay, فعنا يعني إحنا تقريبا تحتاج 3 to 4 years for proximal lesion to reach dentin. Okay, but this is يعني a good time for the preventive measures in order, to take part. يعني إحنا if, زي ما حكينا دائما بنحكي if we capture the lesion at the time of incipient lesion, then we have time to go and interfere by the preventive measures in order to stop the progression of the lesion. هلا caries on a free smooth surfaces seems to progress more slowly than on a proximal surfaces or in fissures. Okay. شو السبب؟ شو الأسباب؟ إذا بدنا نحكي عن الأسباب ليش؟ إن the caries on a free smooth surface seems to progress more slowly. لأنه the intake of fluoride by the smooth surface is much more than the proximal exposure للفلورايد بيكون والintake up of fluoride بيكون much more in the smooth surfaces and the proximal surfaces more than the fissure surfaces. Okay, وهي حكينا عنها كمان في محاضرة سابقة. حكينا إنه الإفكت of fluoride بجزء الإبيديميولوجي إنه الإفكت of fluoride بيكون more على smooth surfaces more than على fissure surfaces. ليش؟ لأنه take up of fluoride بيكون more في the free smooth surfaces more than the proximal. طبعا هي أقل بعدين بيجي بالترتيب الفيشرز. عشان هيك الفيشرز بنعتمد على وسائل تانية في the prevention. إحنا طبعا الفلورايد more effect في the prevention of dental for smooth surface caries, لكن في ال fissure caries بنعتمد على إشي تاني إذا حتاخدوا عنه لبعدين اسمه fissure sealant. إذا حد سمع عنه هو we block أو we cover the fissures with a material in order to prevent stagnation of the debris and the plaque on the fissures and the development of dental caries. لأنه كمان one of the reasons why we do that we use fissure sealants in the protection is that the effect of the fluoride is more on the smooth surfaces more than the in the bit and fissures. So along with the decline in caries prevalence, they have a come decline in caries progression rate due to the use of fluoride. اللي بدنا يعني نعرفه انه between the initiation of caries and the involvement of dentin, اللي هي احنا لما نوصل الدنتين هاي سميناها البوينت اوف نو ريتين. لما يوصل خلص الدنتين معناته هاي الكاريز ليجن نيد تو بي ريموفد, انه الكاريز هاز تو بي ريموفد اند ذا كاريوس ليجن هاز بي او ذا كافيتي هاز بين should be restored with restorative material. But between this, between the initiation of the caries, يعني احنا بنسميها الانسيبيانت ليجن and the involvement of dentin, there is ample time for preventive management strategy. هذا الإشي المهم and we should concentrate on that. So we have time to interfere and for the patient to help us, طبعا مع الدنتيست in order to reverse the carious lesion and for the remineralization to take place. while free smooth free هاي حكيتها بجوز كمان وانا اشرح عن free smooth surface carries while the free smooth carries seem to benefit the most of the apparent carries decline occlusal surfaces of molars and peep molars have seemed to be the least benefit عشان هيك حكيت لازم احنا نعتمد على more other factors like fissure sealants احنا بنعتمد عليها في the protection against occlusal carries. هلا the degree of destruction caused by caries that allow the lesion to heal or to be arrested is an important question دائما انه احنا وين ال time of no return يعني هلا ممكن انا طبعا احنا بنطبق ال caries protection or protective effect whether في عندنا مش يعني انه ال patient خلص انه صار في عنده carious lesion we will stop no because انه any carious يعني restoration حتى لو عملنا هال restoration ممكن يصير recurrent caries صح ممكن يصير caries around the restoration. بس احنا مهم ليش هاي مهم عشان we do not go and interfere عشان هيك الديتكشن او الدياجنوسز رح تاخدوه كمان يعني it's beyond this course اللي هي detection of dental caries is very important or very يعني complex procedure and not easy procedure into to know إن هلا caries هذا incipient or it has caused cavitated طبعا كل surface بيختلف يعني how to detect caries في the smooth surfaces بيختلف على interproximal surfaces بيختلف عن occlusal أو pit and fissure caries okay فالdiagnosis هنا very important إنه مش مهم الintervention بقدر ما هو مهم الdiagnosis إنه أنا أعرف هل lesion this needs restoration or I can wait and do preventive measures وطبعا it depends on a lot of factors not only the diagnosis but also depend on the patient the care activity of the patient regular checkups by the patient فزي ما حكينا هاي بتاخدوها إن شاء الله في next years different courses about the diagnosis and management of dental caries. الإشي اللي نحكي هون إنه the point of no return we have to also always remember that the point of no return means a need for restoration with very crucial decision in the life of any tooth. ليش crucial؟ لأنه once إحنا مسكنا الهام بيس رح نسميها and we drill the tooth to remove the dental caries يعني إحنا ما في عنا retain. Okay, we have to do a cavity, a restoration طبعا whatever we use the material and whatever the operator or the clinician can experience still إحنا ما بنعمل we will not return the tooth to the same يعني the original shape and form وهذا التوث بيكون معرض for recurrent caries impalpal involvement وممكن يصير عندنا مشاكل فيه اوكي فليش فعشان هيك احنا بنحكي diagnosis very important رح تاخذوه ان شاء الله in next courses ان شاء الله اوكي هذا اللي بدي احكيه اليوم خلصت المحاضره any question about في حدا رافع ايده بس انا مش شايفه